And Dr. Kotiah is joining us now with some more information. Thank you so much for coming in this morning.
Thank you for having me.
We were looking at the piece just now and saying, boy, this could be helpful for so many people, for so many different things.
Actually, they've done studies looking at not just bone marrow transplant patients, breast mm-hmm. cancer patients, but patients with mental illness and patients who are chronically ill, who have, you know, like Crohn's disease or problems that they deal with every day that don't go away. And it actually helps all of those patients in terms of decreasing their fatigue, mm-hmm. sometimes decreasing their pain. And it helps them cope better, helps them express themselves.
So is this something then, let's say someone isn't going to Mercy to receive their treatment, is this something they can do on their own at home too, to help out as well?
Yeah, so they can do that. They can do that at home. Actually, you know, the American Cancer Society has a very good mm-hmm. blurb on art therapy and what it's meant for and the history of it and how it started. It's actually a very nice read if anybody wants to go online and take a look at that. But there's resources at the American Cancer Society website that tell people how they can get to an art therapist or how they can tap into those resources.
It seems like so many different things are going on to try to help patients deal with their chemotherapy and even just sitting with the treatments and how long they can take. So it's nice to find a new way that they can express themselves. And you can have any sort of level, right? You don't even have to know what you're doing.
No, you don't have to know what you're doing. In fact, a couple of my patients, one of them made jewelry with her daughter, mm-hmm. and then the patient designed shoes and, you know, sort of put some paste jewelry in there, and she was very excited about that. So you don't have to have any training. You just have to just use your imagination and come up with a way to express yourself. And it's really funny because one of my patients likes very like simple designs, right. Another patient likes very complicated designs, so you get to see a little bit of their personalities when they make things.
And important to stay busy and not get depressed.
Yes, exactly. That's really the goal, and it does help them with that.
All right, doctor, thank you so much for coming
in. Thank you so much.
We appreciate it. Good information.
Thank you.
And if you have any other questions or you'd like a referral, just call 1-800-MD-MERCY.